Salutations, viewers. My name is Game Dame, and welcome back to another one of Game Dame Reacts. So, we have the official breakdown from the developers on Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, which is not out yet. I always mix up Marvel's Avengers and Guardians of the Galaxy because I always think Guardians of the Galaxy is out, but it's not. It will be coming out. And I hope this will save kind of it from saving grace from Marvel's Avengers, but we shall see. So, let's watch the official developer trailer breakdown for Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy.
My name is Daryl Purdy. I am the cinematic and animation director on Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy.
First, to claim they have captured Atara Tara.
Atara Tara. Prove it.
Our game is a very narrative-driven action-adventure experience with many larger-than-life characters. We use performance capture as our main tool to bring those characters and story to life. Shooting a complex original story with a large ensemble cast and close to 6 hours of interactive cinematics was no small feat.
I would imagine
most
it's
have
not
at
so
least
fall
the
feet.
Five Guardians, and in many cases, other characters from the Marvel Universe, like in this scene with Lady Hellbender.
Lady Hellbender is incredibly badass, though. I like her a lot.
For Lady Hellbender's introduction, it was important to us to play against expectations. What's great is we start to play with those assumptions early in the scene. Star-Lord assumes their monster is superior to the scared, meek little creature ahead of them. However, that meek little monster turns out to be a Tara Tara, a powerful
creature.
In response to its rampage, Lady Hellbender defeats the enraged creature with tenderness rather than brute force. In this scene, we wanted to create an overall feeling that things are not always as they seem.
Hey there, I'm Star-Lord.
Especially when she starts flirting with him. Drax, it cracks me up.
Here Drax. We join the Guardians, led by their self-proclaimed leader, Peter Quill, in an attempt to pull off a con job. Having been arrested and fined, they now owe a considerable amount of credits to Novacore. They devise a plan to sell either Rocket or Groot to Lady Hellbender, an exotic monster collector, as a way to make a quick buck. Once the deal is complete, the Guardians plan to double-cross Lady Hellbender by later sneaking into her fortress and breaking their friend out. Players have the choice to sell Rocket or Groot, and this decision will create different paths in this chapter.
And what were you expecting? Perhaps I can do something about it.
Unlikely.
We'll see, Destroy.
Oh, Drax.
I can be quite forceful.
Peter Quill, I believe she is flirting with me.
Of course you should encourage
humor
this.
Humor is also an important ingredient in the Guardians of the Galaxy experience.
Well, yeah,
and
it's Guardians of the Galaxy.
Flipping expectations helps us with this as well. Star-Lord is the sweet talker, the charmer, the natural negotiator of the team. But Lady Hellbender seems less interested in him and more intrigued with Drax the Destroyer. Drax seems somewhat unsure how to respond to this attention. This sets up another great moment where the player gets to choose. Do you rely on Star-Lord's charm, or do you hand it over to Drax and hope he can leverage Lady Hellbender's interests to the team's benefit? You will have to play the game and decide for yourself to see how the negotiations with Lady Hellbender go.
Hey there, hi, I'm Star-Lord. Drax is actually with me, the leader of the Guardians of the Galaxy. You may have heard of us.
You? No.
Oh, well,
I remember that from the original trailer.
Now you have.
The fucking card gets me every time.
Lucky me.
You got this, probably. The developer kind of explained already what I was kind of thinking when I originally saw this, but I do really think that this could put the Marvel games back on the map just because they are I feel like it's the comedy in this is not forced as much because Guardians of the Galaxy is naturally like that in general, where I feel like Marvel's Avengers, I feel like the comedy is a little bit more forced just because it's not naturally like that with them. But it sometimes was in the cinematic movies, but I mean, I think this is going to be a pretty decent game. I hope it just doesn't become exactly what Avengers was, though. So let me know in the comments down below what you guys thought about this developer trailer breakdown in comparison to the original trailer that came out with it. doesn't seem like there was much added on to it other than just really highlighting what they were actually talking about. That was something we probably already knew. But that is all the time I have for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I highly appreciate your time as always. But please do not forget to subscribe and or follow, not only to my YouTube, but to my Twitch. You guys know my YouTube is up. You can find my Twitch at twitch.tv/thegamedame. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.